Hi students, we are seeing MCQs questions from the chapter Hello Alkanes and Haloarenes. Today we are going to see another set of questions. Okay, so let's get started. So what is the question? When benzene diazonium chloride is treated with cuprous chloride in HCl, chlorobenzene is formed. This reaction is known as. See, what is benzene diazonium chloride? This is your reaction, your N2Cl. This is prepared from aniline, isn't it? It is prepared from aniline. When you add copper chloride and HCl, you will get chlorine. Okay, so this is Sandmeyer's reaction. Okay, and one point, students, if you use copper powder and HCl, it is Gaterman's reaction. Okay, you will get the same product, but that naming reaction is known as Gaterman's reaction. Okay, so don't confuse yourself. So, which is the most reactive towards SN1 mechanism? So, they have given a set of alkyl halides. They are asking which is more reactive towards SN1 mechanism. So, in SN1 mechanism, we know the order. Tertiary first, secondary and primary. Okay. So, now first label the type of carbon. See, chlorine is attached to this carbon. What type of carbon it is? It has two hydrogens, so it is a primary. Here, the bromine is attached to this carbon, isn't it? See, bromine, hydrogen, one is C6H5, the another is also C6H5. This carbon is attached to only one hydrogen, so it is a secondary. And here also, this is a secondary, okay? And this carbon, see, bromine is attached to this carbon and it has no hydrogen, so it is tertiary. Okay, so this one, option D, is most reactive towards your SN1 mechanism. Okay, then the reaction RBr plus NaCN gives RCN plus NaBr. So what has happened here? Br is replaced with CN, or else I can say Br is substituted with CN. Okay, so now this is a substitution reaction, but how to know whether it's a nucleophilic substitution or a electrophilic substitution? You see, your RBr plus NaCN is a source of CN minus. Okay, so CN minus, here this is a nucleophile, this will go and attack this R, so that your bromine will go as a nucleophile. Nucleophile means what? The bromine will take the two electrons that belongs to this bond. Okay, so it goes as a nucleophile. A nucleophile enters and a nucleophile goes out. A nucleophile substitutes and another nucleophile. So this is a nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay, got it? So the IUPAC name of the compound shown below is, see, so here we have to give the IUPAC name. So here comes a question, how to number this compound? So we have to number in such a way that all the substituents get the least number. Okay, so there are several options. Okay, so now I will give like this 1 2 3 4. Why not, ma'am? 1 2 3 4, like this. If I give in this direction, okay, if I give in this anticlockwise direction, the chlorine gets the 2 number and bromine gets 6. Okay, so if I give like this, okay, 1 2 3, chlorine also give the takes the least number and bromine also takes the least number. So what is this? So this is 3-bromo-1-chloro. And what is the root name, students? This is a cyclohexane. It has a double bond. So, cyclohexane becomes ene. Okay, cyclohexane. To that, in one position, there is a chloro. And in three position, it is bromo. So, in alphabetic order, bromo comes first. So, okay. So, the option is 3-bromo-1-chloro cyclohexane. Then, the reaction. Okay, so what is this kind of reaction? There is an alkyl halide, it is an isopropyl chloride, reacts with sodium iodide. Okay, what happens? Your chlorine is replaced with iodine. This is a very good naming reaction. What is that? That is known as Finkelstein reaction. Very easy, students. See, if an RCl, okay, or an RBr, okay, reacts with sodium iodide and the solvent is acetone here, what is the react, what is the product? It is just to replace chlorine or bromine with iodine. Okay, the reaction doesn't takes place with fluorine. okay, only chlorine and bromo derivative gets converted to iodine derivative. This is a very convenient reaction. Okay, when Flint-Kilstein's reaction, often for many mechanisms you can also use this. Okay, whenever you want to replace bromine with iodine, you can use this reaction. The addition of HBr to 2-pentene gives. So what is 2-pentene? Pentene. So what is the root name? So tells us that there is a double bond here. Okay, pentene means 5-carbon. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5-carbon. In 2 position there is a double bond. Okay, so rest of the valencies I am going to satisfy with the hydrogen. That's all. So whenever an addition reaction takes place, we have to follow the Markovnikov's rule. Okay, so the nucleophilic part go to the carbon which has least number of hydrogen. Here the thing is, both the carbon have equal number of hydrogen, so you will get two kinds of products. One, the bromine adds up here and hydrogen adds up here. This is one product, and you will get in equal amount. These kind of products you will get in equal amount because there is no differentiation between the two carbons. So how can I name it? So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 2-bromopentane and 3-bromopentane, you will get a mixture of compounds in equal proportion. Consider the following bromides. Okay, the correct form of SN1 reactivity. See, they have told me SN1. Okay, so immediately when I think of SN1, what I will write? Tertiary, secondary, primary. But here you see, so okay, this is primary and this is secondary and this is also secondary. How do I say? Because this carbon has one hydrogen and this carbon, this is skeletal structure, students. Okay, the hydrogens will not be shown. Okay, so you have to think, carbon has 4 valency, so you have to this is logical thinking only. Okay, so there is no tertiary at all. So between these two tertiary, between these two secondary, how can we say the order of reactivity? You know, in SN1 mechanism, what is the transition state? What is the transition state? There will be a formation of a carbocation. Okay, carbocation. So you have to see the stability. Okay, if the stability of the carbocation is more, that alkyl halide will undergo the reaction very fast. Okay, so here I can say in this allyl, no, if a carbocation is formed after the bromine elimination, if a carbocation is formed, it is well stabilized by resonance of this double bond because it is an allyl carbocation. So I can write 2 different, okay, resonating structures. But here for this, both could be, okay, both are secondary nature only, but that additional stabilization is not possible here. So I can say 2 first, third and first. Why? 2, 3, 1. Okay, so it's a secondary and this is primary. Okay, 2, 3, 1. So this first you have to categorize whether it is secondary, tertiary, secondary or primary, and then you have to see the stability. Okay, then you can easily answer. Okay, which of the following is an example of vicinal dihalide? See, vicinal dihalide means, okay, two halogens are attached to the adjacent carbon bonds. This we can say it as vicinal dihalide. So what is dichloromethane? So this is your dichloromethane. The two halogens are attached to the same carbon, so it is a geminal dihalide. Okay, 1,2 dichloroethane. So in ethane CH3, so this is dihalide. Okay, the two halogens are attached to two different carbons, but it must be adjacent to each other. Okay, so what is ethylidene chloride? So in ethane, when we have, okay, chloride, okay, sorry, chloride. So this is also geminal. This is also, what is allyl? A double bond, a single bond, and this is monochloride derivative. So which one is vicinal, students? So this one, okay, 1,2 dichloroethane. Okay, what is ethylidene? This is 1,1 dichloro ethane. Okay, so know the difference, vicinal and geminal. And chlorobenzene is formed by reaction of chlorine with benzene in the presence of AlCl3. Which of the following species attacks the benzene ring in this reaction? See, what is this, students? What is the naming reaction? AlCl3, and we use chlorine. Okay, so you will get what? You will get chlorobenzene. You will get chlorobenzene. But what happens here? Why should we use the AlCl3 here? See, your chlorine. So this is your chlorine, and when you add AlCl3, your AlCl3 is a Lewis acid. Its octet is not completed. So what it will do? It will grab this chlorine along with this bond. Okay, it will grab this chlorine along with this bond to form. Complete its octet. So AlCl4-. Why this minus charge? Okay, it has taken a chlorine along with this bond. So after taken, okay, so what will be formed here? You will be getting a chlorine plus. Okay, this is an electrophile. It is this electrophile which will go and attack the benzene ring. Okay, so this is an electrophilic substitution reaction, and the active species which is formed is chlorine plus. Okay, so the molecules whose mirror images is non-superimposable over them are known as chiral. So which one of the following is chiral in nature? So this is what? 2-bromobutane. So one bromo position, CH2 CH3. Okay, so this is a chiral carbon which has, okay, four different compounds. So this is CH2, your bromine. Okay, there is no chiral carbon at all, so we don't have to see the mirror image. Okay, so 2-bromopropane. So this is what? Completely it is symmetrical. See, this carbon, same compounds repeat, so this is not a chiral molecule. Okay, this is also not. 2-bromopropane 1-ol. Okay, so 2-bromo, this is what? This is 1-bromine and 1-alcohol, and this, okay, and this is also symmetrical. Okay, see, carbon attached to the same group, so this cannot be chiral. So the answer is 2-bromobutane. You see, the carbon which has a bromine, a methyl, a ethyl, and hydrogen, four different groups. Okay, so first you check the asymmetric carbon, and then you can check the mirror image. Of course, if it doesn't have four different groups, it will have a non-superimposable mirror image for sure. Which is the correct increasing order of boiling points of the following compounds? You see, whenever they are asking for boiling points, you have to see the length of the molecule. If they have the same length, okay, so without any branching, okay, so then you have to see the molecular mass of the compound attached to it. Okay, so they are, so now we have to see butane, iodobutane, bromobutane, chlorobutane. So butane means we have four carbons, isn't it? We have four carbons. So I am going to write only the skeletal structure, four carbons. So your chlorine means will be of this size, okay, chlorine molecule, and your bromine means of this size, and your iodine means this size. See, they have the same chain length. Okay, so they will be experiencing, you have to check for the van der Waals force here. Okay, so the bigger molecules, whenever they have the same chain length, now you have to compare the size of the atoms attached to it. Okay, higher the molecular mass, okay, higher will be the size of the atom. More the size of the atom, more will be the molecular van der Waals interaction between them. More the van der Waals interaction between them, more the energy you have to supply to break all the interactions. Okay, so the boiling point order will be this one. So first comes your iodobutane, bromobutane, chlorobutane, and your butane. Okay, so if they doesn't have, first you have to look for hydrogen bonding. If they doesn't have, you have to check for the van der Waals force. That's it. Which of the following will have the maximum dipole moment? Okay, so what is dipole moment, students? It is charge into distance. Charge is created by electronegative difference. So when compared to carbon, and fluorine. This has the highest charge because fluorine is most electronegative. So you may think this order, but what happens, the order becomes this one because your fluorine is smaller in size, doesn't contribute to the distance. Okay, your carbon and fluorine bond, even though they contribute to the charge, they doesn't contribute to the distance because fluorine is very small, so they completely overlap with this carbon. Okay, so it doesn't contribute. Okay, it is a product of charge and distance. So what happens, your chlorine, which is bigger in size, okay, which contributes both in electronegativity and charge. So your CH3Cl is the answer. So a Grignard reagent may be made by reacting magnesium with, so you know what is Grignard reagent in alkyl halide. This is a very important topic, okay, in presence of ether. So you need an alkyl halide, magnesium and ether, that's all. So magnesium is there, so no amine, no diethyl ether, okay, it's a solvent we use, that's all, that is not a reagent, only this is the reagent, ethyl iodide. And your next question, the order of reactivity of following alcohols with halogen acids. See, even though they have not mentioned zinc chloride, it is a Lucas test, and we know that for this the tertiary alcohol answers the Lucas test immediately. See, whenever you treat with HCl and the zinc chloride, your RCl, provided this is tertiary, okay, the turbidity forms immediately. Okay, if it is your secondary, this chloride will be formed after some time, it takes some time, so it is insoluble in the solvent, so turbidity appears after some time. And for primary, okay, no result at room temperature, at RT no reaction, so you have to heat it. Okay, so here the order is secondary, tertiary and primary. So this alcohol, the carbon, this is a tertiary, this is a primary alcohol and this is a secondary alcohol. So the reactivity order is CBA, option B. Okay, so aryl halides cannot be prepared by the reaction of aryl alcohols with, okay, so all these reagents are used to prepare only, you know, with the aliphatic systems, easily you can get this. But if you take aromatic alcohol such as phenol, there is no reaction because this is a kind of substitution reaction and it is not possible because your oxygen has lone pair here. Okay, your oxygen has a lone pair here and this lone pair is involved in resonance. So what happens in the resonating structures? In the resonating structures, you can see a double bond character between, okay, which makes the bond very strong, so you cannot break this bond. Okay, so it is due to the partial double bond character. Okay, so this is why your aromatic phenols cannot be converted to the chlorine halogen derivative very easily. Okay, so then benzene reacts with methyl chloride in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3 to form. So what kind of reaction it is, students? So this is an alkyl halide and anhydrous AlCl3. So this is a Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. Okay, so what will be formed here? So you take benzene, okay, as I told you already before. Okay, so here also what happens, this is a Lewis acid, it grabs this chlorine along with this bond, okay, to form the complex, okay, to complete its octet. Okay, so leaving behind your CH3+, okay, so this is the electrophile here and this electrophile will react with your benzene. So this is a kind of electrophilic substitution reaction. Electrophile is getting entered. So what is the product? This is a toluene. Okay, so the answer is this one. So hope you understood something from this video, and meet you all in another session. I'm going to discuss assertion and reasoning type of question, students. Okay, please follow my channel. Thank you.